everybody, I'm Roberto Blake, and today we're going to be looking at the Adobe Premiere Pro timeline tools and how they can help you get organized and edit a little bit faster. So looking at the Adobe Premiere Pro timeline, one of the first things we can do is we can actually rename our video and audio tracks, and this is actually going to help us just get a little bit more organized and put things in their proper place. So to rename our video track, the first thing we're going to do is we're actually going to double click on it. And you're going to see that it says video one here. We're actually just going to rename that, and I'm going to rename it to A-roll so that I know that this is my overall A-roll footage. You can expand or close tracks just by double clicking. And I really do find this to be helpful. And it also gives me a preview or thumbnail of what's on that video track so I can see what's going on. Now on the Premiere Pro timeline, we clearly have audio and video tracks. You'll notice that the video tracks say V in front of them and the audio tracks say A. And this just helps you understand what goes where. If we want to add more audio or video tracks, it's actually very simple. We can just right click and we have the ability to add as many audio or video tracks as we need. When you go into the Add Tracks panel, you do have the ability to decide whether they're going to be placed before or after the current tracks that you have. You also get to decide how many tracks you want to add for both your audio and video. Another neat trick is that you can also increase the number of video tracks just by moving a piece of footage up in the timeline, and that automatically creates a new video track there. So that's actually something that's just really convenient if you want to do it without utilizing the menu system. Next, I want to show you toggle track output. This is actually so that you can decide what is visible and not visible on your timeline. Now you can see that we actually have the eyeball here so that all of our tracks are visible. But if I have a track that sits above, if I go ahead and if I toggle that track output, you can see what is below that track. And so I have the option here to just kind of play around with this, and I can decide which piece of footage actually looks better in this overall sequence. And so I can decide whether or not I want to toggle that back on. Just keep in mind that when you have any of these options toggled off, that they will not display in your video output when you're exporting. So anything you want to see in the final video, you'll need to leave toggled on. Next up is the toggle sync lock on the Premiere Pro timeline. Toggle sync lock is enabled by default on all of your video and audio tracks. I'm going to show you how this actually works. So if I ripple delete a piece of footage in my video timeline here, you'll notice that all of the other tracks actually move in sync once I've deleted that. However, let's go ahead and undo that real quick, and let's take toggle sync lock off of video track 4 and leave it isolated. Watch what happens when I go ahead and I commit the same ripple delete now. Everything in the timeline shifted except for video track 4. Now this could be useful for different situations, but generally you don't want to do this because it will throw the video that you have planned completely out of sync, especially if we're talking about with audio. So unless there's a very specific reason, you'll want to usually leave the toggle sync lock enabled for all of your video and audio tracks. Next up, let's talk about track targeting. When a track is highlighted blue, that is one of the target tracks that we have enabled. And so what that would look like is if I decided that I wanted to copy a piece of video footage here out of whichever tracks I have selected and enabled, it's going to target the lowest overall selected track. And you can see how this would interrupt and disrupt my video. I don't necessarily want to do that. Now, if I have video track 4 highlighted and enabled, and I also go ahead and I hit the paste command, command V, then my footage goes there. It goes to the earliest targeted track in the timeline. So even if I had video track 4 and 6 highlighted, and I decide to paste, it's gonna go to video track 4 instead of video track 6. So just be aware of this when you're editing in the timeline and you want to either place footage using copy and paste or some of these other features. Let's take a quick peek at some of the audio tools in your timeline. You're going to notice that you have the ability to record voiceover tracks in the timeline. This is actually a really great feature in Premiere Pro. And if you go ahead and if you right click and you go into your voiceover settings, you can get a feel for how it works. You see that you get a countdown that's going to help you when you decide to start recording, so you have a little bit of prep time and you can see how that would work. It's also going to help you if you need to test your microphone and know where your audio levels are, and it shows you if you're peaking. Now, in the audio features here on the timeline, you're going to see S and M, and these stand for solo track and they sound for mute track. With solo track, I can actually select this and I can decide that this is the only track that I want to hear, which is actually really great when I want to look at my main A roll and I want to hear just my voice with none of the sound effects and none of the background music going on, so that I can make any adjustments that I need to my audio levels and so that I can just make sure that I got my lines right. So I'll be able to hear this without worrying about any of the other audio tracks. Now, I think what mute accomplishes is pretty obvious. It mutes an audio track. Remember that when you're doing this, that if you want the audio to be in the final export, you'll need to make sure that mute and solo are not selected if you want all the audio that you've put on the timeline to be present in your final video. Last but not least, let's talk about markers. Markers are a great feature in the Premiere Pro timeline because they can really help if you want to edit to the beat of your music, or if you just want to set a placeholder so that you know where you can come back and you can go ahead and do something in an edit. In order to use markers, you just use the shortcut M and it allows you to place those markers. And again, I love this feature because when I'm using audio tracks and I'm doing background music, or I am doing certain sound design and special effects, this really helps me with just knowing I want to place something there. That's it for this video. I hope you guys are able to use the Adobe Premiere timeline tools to speed up your workflow, get a little bit more organized, and edit faster. Stay tuned for the next tutorial in the series where I'll be teaching you how to add audio to your videos and some cool tricks for that. Stay awesome. I'll catch you guys next time.